Okay, so I also try some crossroads.
Come on your ass, strange love.
Why?
Higher than 1080p.
Where'd you get hit from? There he is.
Oh, I see. So Cypher is the organization, not like a person. Okay, that's makes more sense.
Cypher, what?
Metal Gear. Oh. It's B is the one that is the one that still has. Again, whoops, I died. These guys all love their moms.
Oh, yeah. I thought I got that guy. Oh,
well, yeah. Strange love, you gotta kill the mans.
Oh,
lose the video game.
They're cuddled. They don't. They expect some like them, but they don't realize that women are actually human beings.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
We're listening to Lou Reed's The Internet in game.
Eggs?
Around 27. What? Around 27.
Let's do Paunch Hunt. Oh, yeah, no. Insurgency looks. I wouldn't
ask that,
no.
But it looks pretty darn good, especially for an indie game.
Yeah, probably better than Battlefield in some cases.
You gotta remember, the latest.
Depression here is better than Battlefield. Come on.
Frostbite has done the latest. This is using Source. This is using Source.
Using literally an. Oh, okay, the sunlight
yeah,
makes
looks pretty
way
good.
More
yeah.
sense. Yeah, Insurgency looks pretty good. The Metal Gear looks pretty good.
Insurgency still looks pretty good, though.
Insurgency looks pretty great.
Play as ball.
Did the game cut off sometimes?
Didn't suffer long. Years.
Yeah, there's problems with that port. Unfortunately.
You earned it.
Raspberry!
How's it feel?
You know what? The voice is saying use suppressors. I actually wonder if you
no more war games. You're a real man now.
I'm gonna actually try that. See if the suppressor actually works.
It's how do you turn the light?
That's what I've been using.
Geez.
I've been using suppressors. I've been using shotgun.
Let's go to B. Let's do Bravo.
Bravo. We go to Bravo. Yes.
We should go to Bravo. Is group.
Give my regards to your boss when you get home.
It's a little bit better for just running pure NVG.
Oh, I got jacked. Yeah, this map is much better for NVGs. Well, I'm already out of this match.
Yeah, the subtitles are cut off at the bottom because it's cropping the screen. Good job.
All right, to see.
I think I can skip this one. Yeah, I can skip it.
Mission info has been updated.
This is an infiltration mission. You've got to stay out of sight. Before you go any further, use your binoculars to recon the area. What do you see?
Oh man.
Press the call button to get more intel.
So these guys want any woman they're involved with to be permanently stuck in a state of 25?
Yes.
Yep.
He one of them literally said that they start getting angry at 27.
They're not Russian women, they don't turn into hags at 30.
You should be able to listen in on whatever they're pointed at.
But don't they also know that the males around the same age too?
Yes.
Not the time to go easy on intruders.
Your birthday cake, as they put it.
Ew.
You look good, but no one wants a little birthday cake. Is that what it is, Christmas cake?
Christmas cake.
Even casual chatter could reveal something in a place like this.
No, fuck that. It'd be still fresh, I'll eat it.
Delicious Christmas cake.
Did we get B?
No, get is different, because this is,
Hunt.
Yeah, it's one of the three we have the bomb on.
We're basically doing a rocket hellbender.
American.
And when you die, you stink. I say, Ned, if you looked at that Haji, he fucking just wrecked
it. I saw him out of the corner of my eye, and DG screwed my peripheral.
Yeah. Do you have Incendiary on you?
I have Incendiary and an RPG on me.
Alright, I'm moving towards A.
I'm Brenner.
Actually, I'm
C4. I'm Brenner.
I saw the C4.
They're all over A.
Well, this is gonna end well for me.
Yep, good luck, dongs. Remember, you have to blow up the point and to kill all the mans. Good luck!
Yes, or just kill all the mans. By the way.
Yeah, like the
if you're gonna be running NPs, don't run Hollow Sight.
Yeah, I can just
yeah, Hollow is terrible for fucking NPGs. Red Dot's Red Dot.
Yeah, Red Dot's it's on.
I got a Cobra, that's what I got.
Cobra's actually really good.
I like the same little man with go to B first.
Yep. Actually, like the 3X. Go B. Docker 3X, no. Do we have an actual dedicated sniper? Because on this kind of game, a proper Wookiee might actually be good.
What are you saying? I should just go on my ass. I got.
Oh, they got me.
They got me.
Oh, they got me as well.
I forgot that the 249 is not straight with running around.
Alright, I will equip Ace.
Yeah, I'll actually go over to like the RPK. Which is pretty sweet.
Anybody see that?
And the tower. So you can blow up the towers, but...
Wait, you can blow up the towers?
Yeah. The wood ones.
Not twin ones, you need an airplane for that. You can't pilot that in the game.
Yeah, the wooden watch towers.
Oh, yeah, get the most of them. Mosey.
I wanna go Mosey, I've got an
M16. I'm one of the snipe.
Oh, I was looking for a C for something, but I remember that it's in there.
Shoot him!
Shoot him!
Shoot him!
Well, next time, shoot him in the head.
That's where I was aiming. Under my iron sights are off.
Need to check your zero, brah.
Check yourself before you wreck yourself.
I actually legit had to check my zero on my AK.
Now you have to kill 11 more people between the two of you.
Like my real life AK.
Yeah, no, I get you. But like I'm saying, you were having problems with it or what? You've got to stay out. You can do a trip.
My AK was, zero inches higher than what we thought it was. My pistol zero was off too. Actually,
you're in Detroit. I just want you to know that.
Hey, Time, you might want to grab my M16 if you can. You'll
find the target. He does have a better M16 than you, Time.
But I'm running a heavy barrel in 3A.
He loses ammo, though, isn't he?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he still loses all his ammo, even though that doesn't make any sense.
I was like, I've got a 3X and a heavy barrel on mine.
I wish you could just savage from a corpse that you took the gun on and get the ammo back.
What's wrong with the heavy barrel? The map,
objectives. Another heavy barrel's worth it.
No, he was saying, yeah.
Oh no, hell dude. Fucking love it.
It's all benefits, why would it be bad?
Yep. Oh wait, it's not, yeah, it's Battlefield, what the fuck?
And that's what kills me, is, you know, Battlefield is heavy barrel and match ammo, or just heavy barrel for lower recoil.
Oh yeah, but better accuracy also.
But Battlefield is very strange. decides that you take a heavy barrel means you're also infiltrated.
Ah. Yeah, I guess that's fair.
I don't know why. All M16A4s are heavy barrels.
If time
doesn't the M16 require you to have a fire match grade ammo or it like explodes?
M16's tolerances aren't that tight anymore, dude.
They've never been that tight.
They've been tight.
I mean, literally explode, yeah. I meant.
Well, I mean, let's put it this way, it can underperform, but it's still incredibly accurate. That's one of the reasons why we're still using it as a service recovery.
What is it, 500 meters?
Oh yeah, 500 meters. Like an effective onto a point target, 550. Area target up to 850.
I remember I used to get, because I realized what weapon it was in America's Army 2, back when I was like 14.
Nice.
No, that dude, I actually legit got using the
M16. Nice. Alright, I'm gonna set up in this position and cover you boys when you're RPK.
I'm gonna set up with my ass like a rifle.
Careful hanging up there without a heavy scope. Yeah, I can see a lot further than you can.
My friend hiding in marijuana fields.
Are you not playing the... Wow.
Does it spawn in random locations?
Yes.
We're literally doing a sneak raid. These guys are out far.
I'm not hearing more.
I really wish it was blow up the thing or kill the mans.
Oh, I got cut. I only killed one.
Man, they came all the way up here?
Yeah.
Why don't we just call in A-10s and Maple?
Or security, perks.
Yes, we're not actually military. No, we wear military uniforms and have very great weapons.
Well, in that case, that's white phosphorus everything, since we don't have to answer to the
new engine. That's why we're less checks and insurgents.
Funny
and
enough,
have hollow point ammo.
Funny enough, yeah, PFCs still actually are bound by the Uniform Code of Military Justice.
Commit war crime.
That did change in 2006.
Which makes no sense, as I have hollow point rounds and my guns at home.
Yeah, but you're not doing war. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, that's why.
Well, here's the thing, though. Like, I mean, it would make more sense from a standpoint of war that you actually want to eliminate them as being a threat. If you blow off a leg or cause severe tissue trauma, they're not really a threat.
You should stop moving whoever's. AKA the only M, you should stop moving. Let me catch up with you.
Yeah, I've always questioned that. I always let the, you're not allowed to use 50 kills. People's like, when we were
shots? It's really a myth? I mean, you can, supposed to use it on people, but you can.
No. The ammo that we were disposing of, you can't. EOD guys are. My dad was with, was a word to dispose of their solid ammo. 50.
Oh, okay.
And, when I was asking the leg, is we gotta go shoot ammo too, so. 15 year old me is not gonna say, this is. Oh my god, I gotta shoot a 50. Yes, please.
Yes. 50's great, dude.
Found out they weren't allowed to shoot with the solid slugs anymore, but you are allowed to shoot with the default ammo of the M82, which is a GI.
High explosive incendiary?
Yep.
Yes. You're not supposed to shoot people with slugs because the slugs cause too much physical trauma.
Oh.
Now, which baffles me because you're shooting somebody with high explosive incendiary ammo instead.
Yeah. Like, that's what I mean, like, that's the thing, it's like, those things are crazy. The really fucking awesome thing, though, is slap rounds.
Frangible?
No, it's disabled light or piercing. It's a 30 caliber spear stuffed inside a 50 caliber wad. So you get a 30 caliber, like, tungsten spear at the same velocity as a 50G round.
It's kind of cool.
It is ridiculous. It is meant, like, we're not supposed to use them in fucking sniper rifles. They're meant only for links for the M2.
Use them for, like,
armor, getting armor?
Pretty much, yeah, that's why it's disabled there for 30 years.
Like against like a BMP or something?
A BMP, technical, pretty much anything. I mean, if they're behind cover, you can use it on mass, destroy the cover.
You need to save a round of fucking technical.
Yeah, that 50
you
would just
really would,
that.
But at the same time, fuck it, it's a slap round, let's use it.
Oh, yeah, it's just like a thing that you should have done every year as an armor. Guy was doing a. I don't remember what the hell it was. It was an interview, and he was talking about one of the funniest things he ever heard as a tank commander was another tank. Sabo, what was it? Gunner? Or loader? Sabo? He was pointing out an enemy sniping the Sabo around. Nice. Probably turned that poor fucker inside out.
Nice, fuck it. I mean, that sounds terrible. Jesus Christ, that would have been me. But, fuck that guy.
Like I said, the dude was probably literally turned inside out.
Well, I mean, yeah, he pretty much turned into a fine pink mush.
I think I found it. Yes, I did.
You got anything to blow it up?
No, I do not, and I'm down.
Okay. Head day. Everybody gather up where I am. So,
there is at least one guy back there, there's probably more.
Kerberos, have you seen that video of Briss calling close air support? They call it a 10 strike too close to their position and freak out?
Yes, I have.
Did you ever read the comment on that video?
No, I did not.
All these people are like, oh, I see a ship cam, okay, out of all the pilots you could have provided ground support for, the A-10 pilot's probably the highest trained because of what they're shooting.
They're shooting a fucking Gatling gun with wings. That's all it is. It's ridiculously impossible. I don't know how it still manages to fly.
And, I heard it doesn't have an engines. It's just so badass it flies in the air. It's just fuck gravity.
Fuck gravity. About right. It's an
infiltration. Blow up?
No. No joke.
Lean more explosives.
Have you ever seen one of the A-10?
No, I actually never looked into it because I couldn't be one, which kind of sucks.
Actually, the A-10 doesn't have the eyesight requirement that a lot of the other ones do.
Really? Well, I was also not in the Air Force, so that was another disqualifying factor. Yeah, but the Marine Corps don't.
Oh, man, that'll do it.
You also have to be an officer, and fuck that.
Yeah, I thought Marine Corps had Seahawks. Or did they just drop that project?
Now head east. Well, we have like, the helicopters. Yeah, but again, you still gotta be an officer.
I always heard that there was actually a carrier-based version of A-10 because it's such a short takeoff anyway.
Really? I actually never heard about it. Not saying there isn't, though, just not aware of it.
This is going to be my, last one by this.
Yes, Sam. CQC one anime.
Win or lose. No, I'm not gonna be in the mood. I'm probably just gonna bounce after this. Just hang out by myself.
Like a bitch.
You know why that guy got hit?
Hell yeah!
Alright then, I'm out there.
Because the Marines would probably love to have the fucking A-10.
Oh yeah.
From the Air Force.
Oh god, yeah.
I don't think anybody in the world, anybody that's not against us wouldn't love to have a fucking A-10 though.
It is pretty great.
But, they have to hit, they have to put a full burst of ammo into a very small area repeatedly on both passes in order to qualify.
Aren't they trying to replace the A-10 with something?
Oh.
They are, and they're probably going to fail just like they have the last 10 times they've tried.
They've been trying to replace the Mod 2s for like 20 years.
Well, they've been trying to replace the A-10 for a long time, too, and the problem is that it's really hard to do...
There's only one vehicle that actually sufficiently sets need in that yet.
Yeah, and the problem is that the replacement thing proposing for the A-10 don't do the job as well.
No.
Like, seriously, there's been reports of enemy combatants surrendering when an A-10 starts flying Overwatch.
They surrender to fucking like drones and everything. It's ridiculous.
To be fair, you know, I would probably panic if an A-10 started doing overhead flights too.
So. See, all of a sudden you just hear them.
You hear Godzilla? You hear Godzilla? Come to life.
You don't even hear that. That's the crazy part about that gun.
Yeah, you don't hear that after you're dead.
Yeah, if
I don't think if you're dead, you're hearing anything.
You hear that if you're lucky.
You hear the A-10 opening up on you. And that is such a crazy worn out. That gun will be as loud as the
hardest
thing to knock out.
Yeah,
they do it all the time at Battlefield 4.
I've seen the fucking.
That's wrong.
Why did you all die? I am not running a weapon that is meant for killing men.
You fucking die.
Problem.
So I noticed.
The F-35 is such a piece of shit.
See, the F-4, the reason we use the F-14 for so many fucking years is because it was unparalleled for a long time. Good old Tomcat.
Well, and the only reason they really switched the Tomcat away from the Tomcats is because the fucking thing was literally falling apart. The F-15.
Yeah, because they were like fucking 25 plus years old shit at that point.
But you know what baffles me is that the Supreme have the mount for the Phoenix missile.
Shit! I ain't got no blowity up things.
You also have to kill 7, 13 more dudes.
I can do it. I got the gun for it.
I don't know. It confuses me.
Seriously, dude, like, there's so many things they want to replace, and they're just like, well, we can't come up with anything. You can cut her. Okay, then don't replace it.
Just to update the shit that's inside that needs replacing.
Well, that's what we did with the M16A4.
The problem is that the F-14 was getting to the point where it was literally falling apart.
Yeah. The stock we had were just so overused at that point.
Did you hear about the F-15 that literally just fell out of the air a couple of years ago?
No.
That was what was happening to the F-14.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, F-15 killed the pilot because it literally just the airframe collapsed, basically.
I can believe it. Okay, where the fuck are all these terrorists?
Right behind you!
Terrorists. These terrorists.
Well, you know what's hilarious is that it's like the NRAPs are really kind of a shame.
Yeah, it's got two tanks, man, 100 gallons.
And they're trying to replace the Bradley with a Stryker. The Stryker, I think the Stryker still had that design flaw in it.
Ugh.
Took
that thing is not a precision fucking weapon.
Does the, Yeah, does it still have that critical design flaw in that you can shoot through the real levels with a standard bolt?
I have no idea, actually. I know that when the Bradley was first developed, it was it had aluminum armor, which, you know, was toxic with birds.
Yeah, the Bradley had a few issues, too. I would
say the worst.
I would argue the Bradley still had, especially.
Yeah, I don't remember what model of the enemy was being used. But, nah.
What kills me is we haven't gotten rid of the Abrams in the old prison area.
The Abrams pretty sweet. There.
You didn't see the reports of RPG-7's penetrating Abrams armor, did you?
I actually was hearing about RPG-7's taking 20 hits to get inside of a fucking Abrams. When we first forced into Iraq in 2003. There were reports of...
I wonder if it was RPG-7 fans or something inside even like RPG-14 or 16.
Possible.
The 16 was found with the Abrams pretty easily, but the 16 is extremely... Not like the Mayfield by Jihad Johnny there.
Yeah, pretty much.
Oh man, did you, you remember that thing that came out in Lively a while ago where someone got himself blown up by an Apache because of snow?
I had not, actually.
It caused a really big stink. It's just like the opening days of the Iraq War, and the reporter was sitting on, or the news guy was sitting on top of a rooftop with the insurgents, and he pointed a camera mount, a shoulder-mounted camera at an Abrams tank, and the 50-gunner popped in.
And the 50-gunner was correct, so.
Yeah, the public was, a lot of the public was freaking the fuck out, and most people are like, you know, when you're under fire from a 50, you can point something that looks like a rocket launcher from 200 meters away at said 50.
No, you really don't.
But, so this guy... And the audio is pretty interesting because the live leak audio was edited, so you couldn't hear the gunner talking to the pilot in HQ.
No shit.
So they're flying into a suppressor. Rangers, I think it was, or something like that. And they say, hey, do we have friendlies east of the position, blah, blah, blah. And they confirm twice that there's nobody there, and so they're looking at it, and they see a crowd, you know, this crowd of people leave the house and walk towards the battle. Some of them are armed with AK-47s, and one of them is wearing a shoulder-mounted camera. The Apache gunner, they try to get into a better position to get to see what the hell is going on. And the other guys took cover because they didn't know what the fuck was, you know, there was a helicopter in the air and gunfire and shit like that. And around the corner you could see the camera sticking out around the corner, and the patch gunners and fucking lit him up.
Good fucking.
And all these and what happens is after they light him up, these two vehicles come out and start trying to recover the wounded. And before ground forces and security they start shooting.
Wasn't that video leaked?
Yeah.
Yeah, I saw that video. It just fucking... I think people were more mad about the way the Apache pilots were fucking talking about killing them more than anything.
Everybody I talked to was like, oh my god, he killed an unarmed regular reporter. What the fuck's wrong with him? Well, it looked like he was holding an SAT.
Head for the old prison.
It's an SAT.
You'll find the targets there. If you're unsure of what to do next, use your eye drawer.
Looks remarkably similar to what the man was holding. And at this point, it's like, hey, guess what? I'm gonna wait for verification to see whether or not he's actually holding a rocket launcher.
Crazy part. The gunner actually is literally saying, hey, do we have any friendlies east of this position? Do we have any friendlies out here? Somewhere out of sight. And they're trying to get the pilot's name and the gunner's name and everything like that. Later on, you find out one of the people trying to recover the wounded had kids in the vehicle, and the kids were wounded. And you can hear the gunner starting to freak the fuck out when he realizes he's just shot at some kids. And it's like, these guys are... And a couple of people really fucked the pooch on this one. The gunner's not one of them, I'm sorry, guys.
No, it really wasn't him.
Yeah, because he's like, how far is he? Like about a mile away? He's zooming in on a fucking TV camera, so, like, you know, you ain't gonna see shit. Really, with that.
But you know what, I don't feel bad for the reporter at all, because he didn't bother telling anybody he was out there. And when you're walking around an area you're not supposed to be in, and you're armed and you're holding what looks like something shoulder-mounted, and you're walking towards a position and the helicopter's flying into support, guess what, you deserve to have happen to you. Boss.